Hi, my name is Judy Nguyen, and this is my poster for ISTE 20, Three Techniques for Teaching Social Justice. So in this poster session, I'll discuss online polling tools, podcasting and audio resources, and virtual reality tools. So let's start with polling tools. So the reason why I like polling tools is because it can enhance classroom engagement, increase student participation in discussions, and reduce student anxiety when discussing difficult topics. So you can use polling for many different ways, you know, just to get immediate feedback and see if they're learning, but you could also use it for discussions. And when you use the tools in a way that they can respond anonymously and open answer, you can get a better response. Or as far as more responses, right? You get at least about 80 to 90% participation versus just relying on raising hands. And then when you make it anonymous, you provide an opportunity to, for students to be a little bit more honest, maybe even more vulnerable than they would when raising their hands. It also gives the opportunity for students to see what other students are thinking without identifying who those students are. So some of my favorite polling tools are Slido. That's a Google Chrome extension that works with Google Slides. ClassFlow is a lesson delivery tool that's absolutely free. And they have a polling tool that's called Creative, where students can draw, add pictures. So what I like about ClassFlow is that you could, you just have more polling tools than you would in some of the other ones. Socrative is really good because it has some fun like erasing ones, and you could also do quizzes. Poll Everywhere also has a good number of options. It works with PowerPoint too. And Mentimeter has some cool things too, like for cloud Q&A. So a lot of them do the same things, and some things do things a little bit differently, but I would definitely check those out. And so in your classroom discussions, when you're talking about certain hot topics, you know, using the polling tools is a good way to kind of see what where they're at as far as their understanding, their opinions, and it could be a really great experience as far as opening the class up to just see where they're at on these things. So podcasts and audio resources. So I use this a lot in my classes, especially when teaching social justice, because sometimes we didn't have certain voices in the room, and to provide an authentic experience, I would look to recordings or stories of, to get those different perspectives. And these are my favorites. So StoryCorps, I really like. It's just this initiative to record as many stories, and so I think it's in the Library of Congress. And so they actually had a van, and they would go place to place to record stories. And they have an app so that families can record stories through social distancing. And they have the great Thanksgiving listen. So I have one of those resources on my poster session for you to check out. So I would assign my students to record an interview with a grandparent or somebody from an older generation. And then share it with the class. Code Switch is about race identity. It's a really fun one and serious one, and I think they do it really well. Latino USA, they have some really good ones too. Leading with Equity, that's really good for as an educator to think more about how you teach and how you can teach in a perspective that's more equitable. Maybe look at, you know, ourselves a little bit more and give a deeper perspective of how we're approaching our students and how what kind of ways we're introducing certain topics. This, I believe, is a collection of recorded essays, and I like using those. I'll try to find a short one that's around three to five minutes, and if they're good examples for writing, but also gives you different perspectives. So it's really good for the students to hear. When you get a chance, I really recommend that you check out some of the animated recordings. I'm not going to play it now, but check out Facundo the Great. That is a really cute video. And it also approaches the topic of students, especially students of color, how they are treated by the faculty, especially the faculty are not a faculty of color, and the importance of names. So check that one out. And then, so it's first person accounts, the Great Thanksgiving Listen, and this I believe I would. Virtual reality and 360 content is something I've been developing for a while or integrating in my lessons for a while, and it's actually really powerful. So with 360 video and VR, it's a completely immersive experience, and it just uses more of your senses than reading or listening, because you feel like you really are in the situation, you're in the moment. So that there's three apps that I would recommend because of the content. So YouTube has 360 videos available. So you just need to filter it. And there's some that are created by amateurs, but then you could see that there's BBC, New York Times, and there's other media outlets that are producing really high quality work. And so if you have a Google Cardboard, or if you have a VR viewer, that's it makes it more immersive, but they could actually just watch it on a Chromebook. But if you can do it with a Google Cardboard, it's a really, really powerful experience. And another one is Google Expeditions. Unfortunately, so when I proposed this, I didn't know that they were gonna terminate Google Expeditions next summer. So you only have 1 year to use it, but if it's something, you have access to and you do have the devices, I would check it out, because you could lead a tour with your students, and they have some ones that would that really work with social justice as far as like immigration or history, religion. So there's some that you could check out. Google Tour Creator was also really good, where you could have students create tours. Again, it is terminating next summer, so you only have 1 year to use it. But if you're looking for something to do, I really would check out Google Tour Creator. Here's some alternatives to check out. ThingLink, RoundMe, and Infiniscope. Check those out. Infiniscope, I think, are just tours. I don't think you could create anything. But ThingLink and RoundMe, the students can use 360 images and create their own tours. So that's a really quick introduction of what I'm going to talk about in my poster session. And then I could just talk a little bit more about how I use those to promote social justice or create an environment for the students to really get a different perspective, or to challenge their perspectives, or to confirm their perspective. But these are really good tools, in my opinion, to create that atmosphere of challenging students and getting to think about other people and other perspectives. That's my contact below if you want to have any questions. You can find me on Twitter at Mrs. Judy Nguyen. And my website for more resources is bit.ly/Judy ARVR3D. Thank you, and I hope to talk to you during the poster.